Arduino versus Raspberry Pi. In this video, I'm going to look at the Arduino and Raspberry Pi, the strengths and weaknesses of each, and how to choose which one is most appropriate for your next project. This is designed as an introduction to both platforms for a future video showing how they can be used together to get the best of both worlds. So which is best, Arduino or Raspberry Pi? It really depends on what you want to do with them. Each platform has their own strengths and weaknesses. Just like how a hammer is great for driving in nails, but not so good with screws, and how you wouldn't use a screwdriver to put in a nail, but it's perfect for screws. But if you think that's a cop-out, well, keep watching. There is a significant overlap between the two. It's in that area I'll go into my personal opinion on which is best. But remember, this is just my opinion, and I'm sure some of you feel differently. If so, please leave a comment. But let's avoid a flame war, because I'm a fan of both platforms in different ways. First, I'll give an explanation of what makes each platform unique. If you want to cut straight to the chase and find out the winner, then look for the chapters on this video, but you'll miss out on some of my reasoning if you do. The Arduino has been around as a maker platform since around 2007, about 5 years longer than the Raspberry Pi. They became very popular as a maker platform, which made it easier to incorporate a microcontroller into hobby electronics projects. Because of this, you could say it started a maker revolution, putting computing power into the hands of the hobby electronic enthusiasts. The first thing to point out is that the Arduino are based around microcontrollers. Although it still meets the criteria of a computer in terms of running a program, it's not what most people think of when you talk about computers. Shown here are the two main types of Arduino board, based around the layout of the pins, designed for certain add-on boards known as shields. The traditional format and the MKR or Maker series are currently the most common. They are typically based around the Atmel 8-bit microcontroller used in the traditional boards, or ARM Cortex, such as the SAM-D21 used on the Maker boards. These don't have anywhere near the processing capability of the Raspberry Pi, but because you don't have the overhead of running a complicated operating system, they don't need that. The same with the memory, which is typically between 32 kilobytes and 256 kilobytes of flash memory. Note, that is kilobytes, so a factor of over 1,000 times less than the Raspberry Pi. As I say though, these don't have an operating system as such, although technically you could theoretically run an operating system if you wanted. The way they normally operate is that you have a bootloader in the flash memory which loads your code and then runs directly on the processor. The processor can just get on with the job of running the program and doesn't need to worry about swapping programs in and out of the processor or of remapping memory, etc. So the lack of processor capability and memory doesn't seem so bad after all. Although the 32 kilobyte models can struggle with some complex programs. The big upside, and this is perhaps one of the strongest features about the Arduino, is that without multitasking, a program scheduler, or memory management, it means that the Arduino can run in real time, or at least very close to it, without risk of the program being suspended by the operating system. This makes them very useful for functions that need specific timing, including controlling certain external devices. Some Arduinos have 5-volt input stroke output ports, whereas some have 3.3 volts. The 5-volt is used in the traditional Atmel processors and makes communicating with some 5-volt electronics easier. The 3.3 volts is the same voltage as the Raspberry Pi, which means you sometimes need level shifters and you need to be more careful not to damage the board. Typically, the traditional format are 5 volts, whereas the maker boards are 3.3 volts. But that's not always the case. A useful feature is that some of the ports on the Arduino accept analog inputs. This makes it much easier to connect analog devices without needing an external analog to digital converter. Cost-wise, the Arduino is mid-priced, more expensive than the Raspberry Pi Zero and less expensive than a Raspberry Pi Model B. There are a small price difference between the different boards depending upon their functionality. This is based on buying a genuine Arduino board. You can buy clones much cheaper, and as long as they don't have the Arduino name or logo, that's perfectly legal. Although buying from Arduino helps support the development of future boards, and so most of the boards I have are the genuine Arduino boards, although I do have some clones as well. There are some third-party companies that also add extra functionality or a different format, which may be worth considering. Also, if the cost is important, such as for students, then you may want to look at the cheaper models. Which brings us on to the next thing, which is that you could even create your own. The schematics are provided free online, as such this is a truly open source platform. If you just want a traditional format board, then you're better just buying a pre-made board, but this can be an advantage if you want to create a board tailored to your individual needs or to incorporate into a project. The programming language commonly used in the Arduino is based around C++. This may put some people off if they're just starting in programming. It is, however, well worth learning a new language, and C++ is a good language to learn. There are also some versions of Python that can run on some of the Arduino or Arduino-like boards. There's lots more I could say about the Arduino, which depend upon their use. There's no screen or keyboard needed, which can be an advantage or disadvantage depending upon what your needs are. Some models can save to microSD cards, but most don't have any permanent storage. All these factors that you may want to consider, but hopefully this has given you a brief introduction to what it is. The Arduino is best as a device to control hardware directly, with minimal user intervention, or where human interaction is through a simple homemade interface. In that environment they excel and are extremely reliable. Now to take a look at the Raspberry Pi. The Raspberry Pi is what most of us would consider to be a real computer, in that it can function as a PC connected to a screen and keyboard, and you can accomplish typical tasks such as writing letters and browsing the internet. It also benefits from having a set of GPIO, general purpose input output pins, which make it easy to connect to maker projects. The Raspberry Pi came after the Arduino, but was no less influential, putting true computing power into the hands of makers. There are several models of Raspberry Pi, but the main ones worth considering are the Raspberry Pi 4 Model B and the Raspberry Pi 0 W, which are shown. The processor is an ARM 32-bit processor for the Pi 0 and some older Raspberry Pi models, and a full 64-bit processor for the newer models, including the Raspberry Pi 4. This is a fully system-on-chip computer processor that will run a full operating system. There is much more memory on the Raspberry Pi, typically between about 512 megabytes for the Pi 0 and a whopping 8 GB model available for the Raspberry Pi 4, although that does cost quite a bit extra. It's not really fair to compare that directly with the Arduino, as the operating system and programs running on the Raspberry Pi need much more memory than the Arduino. Typically, the Raspberry Pi will run the Linux operating system. The standard is Raspberry Pi OS, which is based on the Debian Linux. It's a full operating system and includes many applications, including a word processor, graphics applications, and even games. The operating system does not normally run in real time, although it is possible to install a real-time operating system. A non-real-time operating system can be a limiting factor when timing is critical. The processor may be using time sharing between different processors, so your program may need to wait while the operating system kicks in to, say, do some memory management, or if another process needs to run. The GPIO ports mentioned previously are all 3.3 volts and are not tolerant of higher voltages. This means if you connect a 5-volt input to the Raspberry Pi, then you can damage it. And also, if you want to output to a device that needs a 5-volt input, then that might not work. This can be overcome using voltage dividers or level shifters, but it's not as straightforward as the 5-volt Arduinos. Also, the Raspberry Pi does not have any analog inputs. There are a few tricks that can be used to measure some analog inputs, but you may need to use an analog to digital converter, which would add to the complexity of certain electronic circuits. Cost-wise, the Raspberry Pi fits around the Arduino, or at least the genuine models of the Arduino. The Raspberry Pi 0 is less than the official Arduinos, but the Raspberry Pi 4 is considerably more than most Arduinos. In most cases, you also need to factor in the cost of a microSD card and some other peripherals such as a screen, keyboard and mouse, if you don't already have these. Whereas the Arduino can be programmed by connecting it to any other computer, such as a laptop. The newer models of the Raspberry Pi include Wi-Fi, which is not included in many of the Arduinos, so this can be an important factor if you want to connect the device to the Internet of Things. Some Arduinos do include built-in Wi-Fi, and I expect that will become more prevalent on future devices. The Raspberry Pi can be programmed in just about any programming language available. As well as C++, like the Arduino, they can also be programmed in Python, which is a very popular text-based language, or Scratch, which is great for children wanting to learn programming. Again, there is much more that I could say about the Raspberry Pi. They are easy to connect to touchscreens and have audio out. They can also be easily connected to other peripherals, such as a camera or USB devices. Power can be an issue, especially with the Raspberry Pi 4, so that's another thing to be aware of. There are some things that apply equally well to both. Both the Arduino and the Raspberry Pi have great communities behind them and are easy to get started with, so either can be used for many different types of maker projects. As I said previously, choosing the most suitable platform depends upon what you want to do with it. So let's look at some typical scenarios and which one is the best fit. Let's start with a simple electronics project, perhaps a temperature sensor that opens the windows in a greenhouse. The most important thing for this is for it to run reliably unattended, which is a good fit for the Arduino. As the program will be quite simple, there's not much that can go wrong, whereas if it was on a Raspberry Pi, you've got the full operating system running that you have to be aware of. On the other end of the scale, we have the Raspberry Pi with a graphical user interface. If you want to be able to control your program using a mouse or a touchscreen, then the Raspberry Pi is an obvious choice. If you're just looking to control LEDs, or particularly RGB LEDs, also known as NeoPixels, then the Arduino is often the best choice. The Raspberry Pi can do these as well, and I've actually created projects around these, including a disco light and NeoPixel projects that use the Raspberry Pi. But that's because I wanted to use a GUI or web-based interface. The Arduino can provide direct 5-volt control, which is required for NeoPixels, and handles the signalling for the NeoPixels better. Which brings me nicely onto the Raspberry Pi. If you want your programs to be a full web-based interface, perhaps using Ajax, then that is usually better through a Raspberry Pi, which can run a full web server. The next scenario I'm going to give is the Raspberry Pi is education. Here I'm thinking about an individual wanting to learn electronics and programming. There are a couple of reasons for this. One is that the Raspberry Pi has a better selection of languages, but also that most problems with the Raspberry Pi are easier to debug. One of the problems with the Arduino is that if the program doesn't do what you think it should, then with a limited interface to the Arduino, it's very hard to see what's going wrong. This can be helped by using a serial console, such as a PC connected to the Arduino, but it's not as easy as debugging directly on a computer. On the other hand, mission-critical systems are often better handled by the reliable Arduino. This can be due to timing of the real-time response from the Arduino, or just because they are more reliable, recovering from a reboot without the risk of corrupting an SD card. So if you want to run a production line, then an Arduino is often a better choice than a Raspberry Pi, although you may want to look at PLCs or something that is specifically designed for an industrial environment. I'm going to add a few things for the Raspberry Pi here, such as peripherals and a camera, and things that have high processing demand, such as artificial intelligence. On the other hand, another example of where reliability wins would be a burglar alarm system or other monitoring system. There are lots of different examples I could list here, but that gives you an idea of the type of system that works well with the Arduino. I'm also going to put down the Arduino as a winner for low power situations, in particular running for batteries or remote monitoring solutions where you aren't able to run from a mains electrical supply. Which brings us to the crunch time. While there are clearly scenarios that fit better with a Raspberry Pi versus an Arduino, there are also times when either would be suitable. So which do I think wins? In this case, I'm going to use an example of my model railway project. There are some advantages to using an Arduino for reliability, quick boot time and simplicity, but I went with a Raspberry Pi because of the flexibility of the interfacing options, such as a touchscreen and a web interface. The Raspberry Pi Zero is also less than the equivalent Arduino, which gives it a further edge. So I'm going to go with the Raspberry Pi as being the winner for the scenarios where either could be used. although I personally often go for the Raspberry Pi just because I've got so many available. I have literally dozens of Raspberry Pi computers, whereas I've only got one Wi-Fi enabled Arduino, although I do have a reasonable number of Arduinos without Wi-Fi, so that might bias my decision a little. But wait, I'd like to describe one further scenario, which is what this video is really about. So why compromise? There are advantages to the Arduino and the Raspberry Pi, so why not combine both and get the best of both worlds? There are some negatives, such as cost, although using a Pi Zero and a basic Arduino can still cost less than a Raspberry Pi 4, and power usage, again, still less than a Raspberry Pi 4, and space, although there are some ways of reducing that. But for some scenarios, using both together can be a big advantage. You could also make savings on larger projects by having one central Raspberry Pi controlling multiple Arduinos. So how do we use them together? You can use serial communications, as both the Raspberry Pi and Arduino can support serial protocols. This can be as simple as connecting a USB cable between the two. You can also use other serial protocols, such as I2C. Or you can have network-enabled Arduinos, typically using Wi-Fi or Bluetooth, which are controlled using a client-server model. In summary, there are some scenarios where the Arduino is an obvious choice, and some where the Raspberry Pi is better. There are some where either could be used, and in that case, I tend to prefer the Raspberry Pi to the Arduino. But just as important, there are some times when combining a Raspberry Pi with an Arduino can give the best of both worlds. If you're interested in finding out more, then I'll be creating a video explaining how you can use both together. Initially, that will be showing how you can establish serial communications between the Raspberry Pi and a physically connected Arduino. But in future, I also hope to show how a Raspberry Pi could control multiple Arduinos over a Wi-Fi connection. So please subscribe if you haven't already and hit the notification bell icon to get notified when my new videos are released. Thanks for watching.